Students, this is very important video for 7 marks question in intermediate public examinations. Okay, so we are learning circles concept. We are in exercise 1E. So today in this video, I am going to explain about second bit problems. Very, very important. So in second bit, first problem, show that the circles x square plus y square minus 6x minus 2y plus 1 is equal 0. And another circle, two circles are given. So we have to show that these two circles touch each other, maybe internally or externally. So find the point of contact. So if they touch each other, there is a point of contact. We should find that point of contact also. And finally, we have to find the equation of the common tangent at their point of contact. Okay, so for this I will give one formula for equation of the tangent. Okay, so the second bit problems are very, very important for intermediate public examination and also for other exams like MCET, IIT JEE and other competitive exams also. Okay, so this problem is very, very important, repeated in regular exams and instant supplementary exams also. Okay, so now the solution of this problem. So what is the concept of this problem? Two circles are provided. Okay, so immediately we should write the data about center radius of the first circle and center radius of the second circle. Find the distance between two centers, then establish the relationship between relative positions of those two circles. Okay, after that we should find the point of contact by using internal similitude or external similitude, and the next equation of the common tangent. The formula to find the equation of the common tangent is s minus s dash is equal 0. S is first circle, s dash is second circle. This is the equation of the common tangent. Okay, right. So first, given first circle, what is first circle? X square plus y square minus 6x minus 2y plus 1 is equal to 0. Immediately compare with the general equation, then 2g is equal to minus 6, 2f is equal to minus 2, c is equal to 1. So g is equal to minus 6 by 2, 2 bring to right side, then 2 1s, 2 3s. F is equal to 2, 2 cancel, minus 1. Okay. So in this case, center, what is the center? C1, that is minus g comma minus f. So C1 is 3 comma 1. Next, radius of the circle R1. Is equal to under root of g square plus f square minus c. So under root of g square minus 3 whole square, f square minus 1 whole square minus c value 1. Minus 3 square 9, minus 1 square 1, minus 1, 1 1 cancel, root 9. So value of root 9 is 3. So this is radius 1 and center 1 of the first circle, radius and centers. Okay, next, similarly find the radius and center of second circle. Given second circle, what is second circle equation? X square plus y square. Writing the equation from the question paper also very, very important. Some of the students writing the equation not properly. That means in this question paper it is given that plus 2x minus 8y. So some of the students are writing like this, plus 2x plus 8y. Okay, so then we will not get correct answer. So once check whether we write correct or not. So 2g, again compare with the general equation, 2f is equal to minus 8, c is equal to 13. Then what is g value? G is equal 2 by 2, that is 1. F is equal minus 8 by 2, minus 4. Now center C2 minus g comma minus f, that is C2 is minus 1 comma 4. Next, radius. R2 is equal to under root of g square. 1 square 1, f square minus 4 square 16 minus c 13. So 16 minus 13, 3. 3 plus 1, 4. Root 4 is 2. So this is the radius 2. We got center 1, radius 1, c2 and r2. Next, we should establish the relation between these two circles. For that, find the distance between two centers. That is, let it be x2, y2 and this is x1, y1. So now, distance between two centers is under root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. So that means x2 minus 1 minus x1 3 whole square, y2 4 minus y1 1 whole square. So this is equal to 1 minus 1 minus 3 minus 4 minus 4 whole square plus 16. 4 minus 1, 3. 3 square, 9. So 16 plus 9 is 25. Root 25 is 5. So observe, radius 1 is 3 and second radius is 2. So this is C1, C2. R1 plus R2 is also 5. 3 plus 2, that is 5. So therefore, what is the relation? C1, C2 is equal to R1 plus 2, R2. This is the relation. Therefore, given two circles touch each other externally. So this is the conclusion. Okay, in key paper, for example, it is 7 marks question. So for finding center 1 and radius 1, you will get 1 mark. For finding center 2 and radius 2, you will get 1 mark, 2 marks. Next, finding C1, C2 and establishing the relation C1, C2 is equal to R1 plus R2. And for writing the, show that the circles touch each other. Okay, so finally write, therefore, the two circles touch each other. Externally. Okay, so this is the conclusion. So for writing this conclusion, you may get 2 marks. So for writing this data, finally you will get 4 marks. Up to 4 marks you may get. Okay, so this is very easy calculation part. Already we did in previous video. So learn and practice, don't lose these type of marks. Okay, right. So first question completed. Next, second one, we should find the point of contact. Point of contact means we should write the geometry. Okay, so here I am writing center 1. Center 1 is how much? 3, 1, and the radius 1 is 3. Center 2 is minus 1, 4, radius is 1. So radius is 2, second radius. Okay, now we should find the point of contact. For that, draw circles. So first circle radius is 3, somewhat bigger than second circle, and these two are touching externally, right? So this is the geometry of given problem. So the radius is 3 and this radius is 2. This is center 2, minus 1, 4. This is center 1, that is 3, 1. Okay, so this is the suitable geometry. Okay, now we should find the common tangent and this point of contact. This is P, we should find the point of contact and also equation of common tangent at point of contact only. So we have two more tangents. So here, those equation of those two tangents are not required. The question is find the point of contact and the equation of the common tangent at this point of contact only. Okay, so that is the question. So point of contact, point of contact. How can we find the point of contact? This is the point of contact P. So P x comma y divides, that is nothing but internal center of similitude. Internal center of similitude. Okay, so this PXY divides C1, C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2. R1 is to R2, already we learned in previous videos. Okay, that is R1 3 is to 2. Okay, R1 is to R2. So what is the formula for this? It is dividing internally, so mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. This is the formula. So center 1, 3 comma 1, that is x1, y1. Center 2, minus 1 comma 4, x2, y2. This is the ratio mx2, m is to n. M is to N, okay, right. So now substitute M. What is M? 3. So we should learn this formula. Then substitution. So substitution is very simple. M into X2 minus 1 plus N 2 into X1 3 by 3 plus 2. Next 3 into MY2 4 plus 2 into 1 by 3 plus 2. So simplification, minus 3, 2, 3, 6 by 5, 3, 4 is 12, plus 2 by 5. So now 6 minus 3, 3 by 5, 12 plus 2, 14 by 5. So 3 by 5 comma 14 by 5, P 3 by 5 comma 14 by 5 is the point of contact. So to find the point of contact, you will get 2 marks. And final question is equation of common tangent at their point of contact. So this is the point of contact. Okay, next equation of the common tangent. What is the formula for equation of the common tangent? Equation of common tangent at point of contact. Formula is S minus S dash is equal to 0. Just subtract one circle from another circle. That's it. Okay. So this is the equation of common tangent. So what is the first circle equation? X square plus y square minus 6x minus 2y plus 1. This is S minus of. Compulsory, we have to keep brackets. Okay, minus is danger. We should multiply each and every term of bracket with minus. Okay, so x square plus y square plus 2x minus 8y plus 13 is equals to 0. X square plus y square minus 6x minus 2y plus 1 minus into x square minus into y square minus 2x minus into minus 8y plus 8y minus 13 is equal to 0. So x square y square gets cancelled. Minus 6x minus 2x minus 8x minus 2y plus 8y plus 6y. 1 minus 13 minus 12 is equal to 0. Minus 2 common 4x minus 3y plus 6 is equal to 0. Minus 2 bring to right side, 0 by minus 2 become 0. So 4x minus 3y, 4x minus 3y plus 6 is equal to 0 is the required equation of the common tangent at their point of contact. So to finding the common tangent, we may get 1 mark. So finally, this is 7 marks, very very important question repeated many times. Okay, do practice. Next, in second bit, first bit, second problem. Show that the circles, these two are the circles, touch each other. We should show same similar problem. So same, find the point of contact and equation of common tangent at the point of contact. Okay, so same, first take first circle, write the first circle equation, find G, F, C by comparing with general equation. Next, center minus G comma minus F, that means 3 comma 9 by 2. Radius R1 under root of G square plus F square minus C minus 3 whole square 9 minus 9 by 2 whole square 81 by 4. Next, minus 13. 4 LCM, 4 9s 36 plus 81 minus 52. So, root 65 by square root of 4 is 2. So, that is first radius 1. Similarly, find write the second circle equation, G minus 1, F minus 8, C 0, and center is minus G comma minus F, that is 1 comma 8. Radius is minus 1 square 1 minus 8 square 64 minus 0, 64 plus 1 65, square root of 65. It is, as it is not perfect square, write that like that only. Now we should find the distance between two centers, that is C1 C2. Under root of x, it is take it as x1 y1 and it is x2 y2. So under root of x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square. We can use that formula also. Okay, so that means 3 minus 1 whole square plus 9 by 2 minus 8 whole square. 3 minus 1, 2, 2 square, 4. 9 by 2 minus 8, that is minus 7 by 2. Minus 7 by 2 whole square, 49 by 4. 4 LCM, 4 4s are 16 plus 49, that is root 65 by square root of 4 is 2. Okay, next, R1 plus R2 here, 3 root 65 by 2, so that is not equal. That's why find the modulus of R1 minus R2. That means root 65 by 2 minus root 65, 2 LCM, 2 root 65. This one minus root 65, apply modulus, then you will get root 65 by 2. So here C1 C2 and modulus of R1 minus R2 both are equal to root 65 by 2. This says that the two circles touch each other internally. Okay, so if you solve up to this, you may get 3 to 4 marks. Okay, now next, we should find the point of contact. So this is a suitable geometry, circle, bigger circle radius is root 65 and this is smaller circle, that is root 65 by 2 radius. So these two circles touch each other internally. This is the point of contact. We should find the point of contact and find the common tangent at the point of contact. Okay, for that, here P divides C1, C2 externally in the ratio R1 is to R2. Okay, so P divides C1, C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2 externally. Okay, so R1 is root 65 by 2 is to root 65 by 2 divide root 65, root 65 cancel, that means 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is to 1 means 1 by 2, that means 1 is to 2. So R1 is to R2 is equal to 1 is to 2, which is equal to M is to N. So these are center 1 and center 2, x1, y1, x2, y2. Okay. Now, Px, y is equal to formula externally means mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n, my2 minus ny1 by m minus n. Okay. Substitute m 1. Into x2 1 minus n 2 x1 3 by 1 minus 2. Again m into y2 8 minus n 2 into 9 by 2 by 1 minus 2. 2 gets cancelled. So 1 minus 6 by minus 1, 8 minus 9 by minus 1, that is minus 5 by minus 1, minus 1 by minus 1. So therefore point of contact is what? 5 comma 1. Okay, next, finally we should find common tangent, equation of common tangent. What is the formula to find equation of common tangent? S minus S dash is equal to 0. So just to subtract these two circles, that's it. Minus of x square plus y square, write the second circle, then equal to 0. So x square plus y square minus 6x minus 9y plus 13, multiply with each term with minus. Okay, so x square y square cancel, minus 6x plus 2x minus 4x minus 9y plus 16y 7y plus 13 is equal to 0, multiply with minus. 4x minus 7y minus 13 is equal to 0 is the equation of common tangent at point of contact. Okay, so if you solve the problem in this way, you will get 7 marks. Okay, so I will provide two more questions related to this one. Okay, example problem, similar problem to previous problems. So two circles given, show that they touch each other and find the point of contact and also common equation of the common tangent. So these are the hints, solve yourself. So here equation of the common tangent, we can find equation of the common tangent in previous method also, that is equation of the common tangent is S1 is equal to 0. The circle touch each other externally, we will get point of contact, right? So at this point of contact, this is tangent to this circle and this circle. So take any one of the circles and find the equation of the tangent by using this point, that is S1 is equal to 0. xx1 plus yy1 plus g into x plus x1 plus f into y plus y1 plus c is equal to 0. By using that formula also, we can find the equation of the common tangent. Next, example 4, also similar to this one. These are two circles. So first find center 1 of the first circle and radius 1, center 2. Before finding that center 2, divide this equation with, here we have 5, right? So equation divide with 5. You will get minus 8 by 5x minus 14 by 5y minus 32 by 5 is equal to 0. From that you will get center and radius like this. So find C1, C2, modulus of R1 minus R2. And those two are equal to 2. So in this case, the circle touches each other internally like this. So this is the common tangent. Okay. So here, as circles are touching internally, the center C1, this is C2, this is P. P is outside the line segment. That's why P divides C1, C2 in the ratio. R1 is to R2 externally, P is external to C1, C2, right? So P is divides C1, C2 in the ratio externally. So by using mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n, my2 minus ny1 by m minus n, we can find the point of contact, that is minus 1 comma minus 1, equation of the tangent. So this is second circle, this is first circle, subtract s minus s dash is equal to 0. Otherwise, by using s1 is equal to 0. S1 is xx1 plus yy1 plus 2gx. 2 in g into x plus x1 plus f into y plus y1 plus c is equal to 0. Take any one of the two circles. Okay, so this is x1 y1 point and gfc. Take from this circle or this circle. Why? Because this is the tangent touching two circles. That's why take any one of the two circles, you will get same answer. This is equation of the common tangent. Example 1. Show that these two circles having four common tangents and find internal center of similitude, external center of similitude. Simple, same, take two circles, find center 1, center 2, radius 1, radius 2, C1, C2 and establish the relation between C1, C2 and R1 plus R2. Here C1, C2 is root 500. Okay, so R1 plus R2 is 20, that means root 400. Root 500 is greater than root 400, therefore C1, C2 greater than R1 plus R2. One circle is exterior to other circle. In this case, we have two direct common tangents, two transverse common tangents. transverse common tangents intersect at internal center of similitude and direct common tangents intersect at external center of similitude. So internal center of similitude we can find by using it divides C1 C2 in the ratio R1H to R2 internally. Okay, so this is the internal center of similitude and the ratio divides externally. Q divides C1 C2 in the ratio 1:3 externally. By using mx2 minus n x1 by m minus n formula, we will get external center of similitude. Solve yourself and check. Next problem, prove that these two circles has exactly two common tangents. Also find the point of intersection of those tangents. So take first circle, find center 1, radius 1, second circle, center 2, radius 2, find the distance between C1 and C2, you will get 2 root 5, that is root 20, R1 plus R2 is 6, that is root 36, modulus of R1 minus R2 2, that is root 4. So here the relationship between these three is modulus of R1 minus R2 less than C1, C2 less than R1 plus R2, that means these are two intersecting circles having two direct common tangents. Direct common tangents meet at Q, that is called as external center of similitude. So find the external center of similitude with the ratio 1:2. So Q divides the line joining C1, C2 in the ratio R1:R2 externally. So by using mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n, my2 minus n, ny1 by m minus n formula, we can find the point of intersection of those two tangents, that is 8, 5. So solve yourself and check the answers. Second problem, find the equation of the circle which touches the another circle x square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y minus 20 is equal to 0 externally at 5, 5 with radius 5. So this is given circle. Understand the problem carefully. Here I am giving geometry of the related to this problem. This is first circle x square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y minus 20 is equal to 0. We can find the center and radius to this circle. So we should find the equation of the another circle with radius 5 units and these two circles are meeting at 5, 5. Okay. Next we should find the equation of the another circle. Okay. So how can we find? First, given circle. What is the given circle? X square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y minus 20 is equal to 0. 2g is equal to minus 2. 2f is equal to minus 4. C is equal to minus 20. G minus 1. F minus 2. So center of that circle is minus g comma minus f, that is 1, 2. Next radius under root of g square plus f square minus c, g square 1, f square 4 minus c, minus half minus plus 20, that is root 25, that is 5 units. Okay, so here we got center as 1, 2 and radius of the circle is 5. It is given that center of the second circle is 5, but we don't know the center of second circle. So to find the equation of the second circle, we know the radius and center. So already we have radius, it is given in the problem, we should find the center. So these two circles are touching externally at 5, 5, right? So observe, this P is located 5 units from center 1, center 2 and 5 units from center 1. So it is midpoint of C1 and C2. Okay, so therefore P5, 5 is midpoint of C1, C2. Okay, so if you get another value, then write the relation P divide C1, C2 in the ratio R1:R2. From that you can find the center. Okay, now 5, 5 is equal to midpoint H plus 1/2, X1 plus X2/2, Y1 plus Y2/2. So equate corresponding coordinates K plus 2/2 is equal to 5, h plus 1 is equal to 10, h is equal to 9, k plus 2 is equal to 10, k is equal to 8. So center is what? 9 comma 8. Now find the equation of second circle. Equation of second circle. So center 9 comma 8, radius 5. That means x minus h whole square plus y minus 8 whole square is equal to r square 5 square. X square plus 81 minus 18x, y square plus 64 minus 16y is equal to 25. So finally x square plus y square minus 18x minus 16y plus 64 plus 81 145 minus 25 120 is equal to 0. This is the required equation of the circle. Third problem, find the direct common tangents of the circles. Two circles are given, we should find the direct common tangents. So to find the direct common tangents, we need external center of similitude. So we can solve this problem in two methods. I will provide those two methods. Okay, so listen carefully. Same method, that is, take first circle and find center 1, radius 1, second circle, take center, second circle, radius center and radius, find the distance between those two centers and establish the relation between those two circles. So for that you will get 3 to 4 marks. Okay, simple. For every second bit, for every problem we should find centers, radius, okay, then c1 c2 and r1 plus r2 or r1 minus r2. Okay, so take first circle. Given first circle, what is that? X square plus y square plus 22x minus 4y minus 100 is equal to 0. So here 2g is equal to 22, 2f is equal to minus 4, c is equal to minus 100, g 11, f minus 2. So therefore center, first center, that is c1, is minus g comma minus f, that is minus 11 comma 2. Okay, next radius. How can we find radius? By using the formula g square plus f square minus c. So under root of g square 11 square plus f square minus 2 square minus of minus 100. 11 square 121 minus 2 square plus 4 minus of minus 100 plus 100. So this is 225. So radius on is root 225 means 15. Next, what is second circle? Equation x square plus y square, this one, just a symbol change, numbers are as it is. So here you will get g is equal to minus 11, f is equal to plus 2 and c is equal to plus 100. So here in this case center is minus g comma minus f, that is 11 comma minus 2. Here minus 11 comma 2, here 11 comma minus 2. And radius is r2 under root of g square minus 11 square 121, f square 2 square 4, minus c is 100. So r2 is equal root 125 minus 100, 25, that is 5. Okay, next find the distance between those two. Okay, so here direct no need. Okay, fine. C1 C2 is equal to under root of 11 minus of 11, 22 whole square minus 2 minus 2, 4 square. Okay, so you will get 22 square, 22 484 plus 16, that is 500 means 5 into 100, so that means 10 root 5. So not required here, no need to find C1 C2. Directly he asked to find the common tangents of the circle, direct common tangents. So here R1 is 15, R2 is 5. That means the circles are like this, R1 and r2 is 5. C1, C2, r1 plus r2 is 15 plus 5, 20. So this is C1, C2. The observation is C1, C2 is greater than r1 plus r2. Clearly, C1, C2 is root 500, C, r1 plus r2 is 20. So root 500 is greater than 20, means root 400. So the circles are like this, will not touch. The circles will not touch each other. One circle is exterior to another circle, like this. Okay, so these are the direct common tangents. They will meet at Q or P. Let it take as P. So this is C1 and this is C2. This P divides C1, C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2 externally. So we should find the to find the equation of the direct common tangents, we should find the external center of similitude. We should find the external center of similitude. So this C1, C2 is not required, that is your interest. Now we should find the equation of the direct common tangents. So it is somewhat a lengthy problem, but do carefully. Okay, so first given circle, find C1 R1, C2 R2, then P is the external center of similitude. Okay, so P divides C1, C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2, that is 15 is to 5, 3 is to 1, 5 1s, 5 3s externally. Okay, so what is the formula? P x comma y is equals to mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n, my2 minus ny1 by m minus n. Okay, here m is 3, this is x1 y1, x2 y2, 3 into x2 11 minus n 1 into x1 minus 11, this is m, this is n, by 3 minus 1, again 3 into y2 minus 2 minus 1 into y1 2 by 3 minus 1. So 33 plus 11 by 2, 3 minus 2 6 minus 2 by 2, so that is 44 by 2 minus 8 by 2, 22 comma minus 4 is the external center of similitude. Okay, so till here, in two methods till here we should find. Okay, so half of the marks, more than half of the marks you will get. Okay, if you don't know how to solve the next direct common tangents, so do till here. Okay, you will get 3 or 4 marks. Okay, now next we should find equation of the direct common tangents. So we can use pair of direct common tangents by using s into s11 is equal to s1 square. Okay, so here this is the point, and take any one of the two circles, take any one of the two circles and find. Okay, so I will give direct answer for this one. So this is finally we will get pair of straight line equation, like ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. We should split that equation, okay, or keep like that only, no problem. Okay, in another method we will get directly two different equations. So by using s into s11 is equal to s1 square, you will get s is equal to this one, s11 is equal to 900 by substituting 22 comma minus 4. This is s1 x into x1 plus y into y1 plus g into x plus x1 plus f into y plus y1 plus c. By using that one, take any one of the circle g f values and write that s1.
then substitute those all values in s into s11 is equal to s1 square and simplify that one, you will get combined equation. In this one we have two combined equation, product of these two straight lines will get this one, okay. But we should get the two common tangents equation indifferently. That means in form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, okay. So you can follow this method, or this is right method, this is suitable method what I am doing, okay. So you can follow s into s11 is equal to s1 square in critical positions, but do this method. Point 22 comma minus 4, this is external center of similitude. Let the slope of this tangent is m, slope of the tangent is m, then what is the equation of this line with the point slope form? Equation of tangent is y minus y1 is equal to m into x plus x1. This is x1, y1. Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1, 22. Okay. So, y plus 4 is equal to mx minus 22m. So, bring to left side, mx minus y minus 22m minus 4 is equal to 0. This is the equation of the tangent. Next, here observe one more important point. Take C2 or C1, take this circle or this circle, think. So here, as this is tangent to both circles, the radius and perpendicular distance from the center both are equal. So what is the center of the first circle? That is 11 minus 11 comma 2 minus 11 comma 2 and center radius is 15, okay. Already we got first circle radius is minus 11 comma 15 and center is minus 11 comma 2, okay. Now here the concept is, as this is tangent line, the radius and perpendicular distance both are equal. So this is the tangent line, this is the tangent line, and here radius of first circle, you can take second circle also, is equal to perpendicular distance from C1 to this tangent equation, okay. So what is the radius of the first circle? 15, which is equal to perpendicular distance from minus 11 comma 2 to this line. So that is minus m into minus 11 modulus of mod ax1, right. So minus 1 into 2 plus c, minus 22m minus 4 by under root of m square plus minus 1 square. Do cross multiplication, 15 into under root of m square plus 1 is equal to modulus of minus 11 minus 22 minus 33m minus 2 minus 4 minus 6, okay. So here 3 is mod, minus means plus, 3 common, right, 3 common, then you will get 11m plus 2, 3 ones are 3 5s are, squaring on both sides, you will get 25 into m square plus 1 is equal to 11m plus 2 whole square. So 25m square plus 25 is equal to 11m whole square, 121m square plus 4, 2 to the 4, 4 11s, 44m, okay. Here you will get a quadratic equation, 121 minus 25, that is 96m square, next plus 44m minus 21 minus 21 is equal to 0. So this is the quadratic equation. Factorize this quadratic equation. So the factors are 72m minus 28m plus 72m minus 28m. So this is important step. If you will not get factors, use minus b plus or minus under root b, b square minus 4ac by 2a formula also, okay. So the factors of this quadratic equation or 72 m minus 28. 72 minus 28, 44, and product is product 2 equal to 96 into 21. Okay, now what is common in these two? 24 m is common, 24 4s and 24 3s minus, here 7 is common, 4m plus 3 is equal to 0. So 4m plus 3 is again common. 24m minus 7 is equal to 0. So 4m is equal to 4m plus 3 is equal to 0, or 24m minus 7 is equal to 0. From this, m is equal to minus 3 by 4, or m is equal to 7 by 24. So slope of this one is 7 by 24, and slope of this line is minus 3 by 4. So substitute these m values in equation 1 or by using slope point form, you will get equations of the two tangents. Okay, so first one, point 22 comma minus 4 and slope minus 3 by 4, y minus y1 is equal to minus m into x minus x1, 4 into y 4y, 4 into 4 16, minus 3 into x minus 3 plus 66, bring to left side 3x plus 4y, 16 minus 66 minus 40 minus 50 is equal to 0. So this is the equation of first tangent. Second one, take point as 22 comma minus 4, this one, and slope is 7 by 24. So y minus y1, y plus 4 is equal to m into x minus x1. So 24 into y, 24 y, 24 into 4, 96, 7 into x, 7x, 154. So finally, rearrange the terms, you will get 7x minus 24y minus 154 minus 96 minus 250. So 1 is 7x minus 24y minus 250 is equal to 0, and another one is 3x plus 4y minus 50 is equal to 0. So these are the two required direct common tangents. Listen once again. So first of all, take two given circles. Find center 1, radius 1, center 2, radius 2, distance between those two, that is not required, but to find the relative positions, we can find C1, C2, we got root 500, R1 plus R2, we got root 400, so the circles here, one is exterior to another. So direct common tangents meet at external center of similitude. Find the external center of similitude by using P divides C1, C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2 externally. Okay, so we will get external center of similitude. Okay, this is external center of similitude. Take the slope as M. Okay, slope as M. Write the slope point form, and here the relation, important condition is radius to the first circle is equal to perpendicular distance from the center to the tangent. Okay, by using that condition and squaring on both sides, you will get two slopes. Okay, so by using those two slopes, we will get two direct common tangent equations. Otherwise, you can follow S into S11 is equal to S1 square. In that one, you will get a pair of straight line equations, means product of these two lines. You will get product of these two lines, you will get. Okay, so very, very important problem. Do practice. Next, one more important problem for 7 marks. So in this problem, we should find it. In the previous problem, we find that equations of the direct common tangents. In this one, we are going to find the equations of the transverse common tangents. Okay, so for that, two circles are provided. Take first circle, find center, radius. Center is 2 comma 5 and radius is 1. Take second circle, find center and radius. Okay, center is minus 2 comma 3 and radius is 3. So this is not required, you can find, no problem. C1, C2 is root 20, R1 plus R2 is root 16, C1, C2 greater than R1 plus R2, so one circle is exterior to another circle. First one is radius 1 and second circle radius is 3, so smaller circle, larger circle. So here the question is about transverse common tangent. These are two transverse common tangent meet at P. This is called as internal center of similitude. Internal center of similitude, which divides C1, C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2 internally. Okay, so to find the transverse common tangents, we required internal center of similitude. To find the external, to find the direct common tangent equations, we required external center of similitude. That is the important point which you should remember. Okay, so for each problem we are finding C1R1, C2R2. So for this only you will get 2 to 3 marks. Okay, next. Now we are going to find internal center of similitude by using C1, C2, R1, R2. So these are the C1, C2, R1, R2 values which we find earlier. So here let P x comma y be the internal center of similitude. This P divides C1, C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2, that is 1 is to 3. Let it be M is to N internally. Okay, so what is the formula to find internal center of similitude? mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. If it divides internally, we should take plus. If it divides externally, we should take minus. m1 x2 minus 2 plus n3. This is m, this is n. 3 x1 2 by 1 plus 3. 1 into 3 plus 2, sorry, 3 into y1, 5 by 1 plus 3. Now minus 2 plus 3, 2 is 6, 3 plus 1, 4, 3 plus 5, 3 is 15 by 4. So my 4 by 4 comma 18 by 4, that is 1 comma 9 by 2 is the internal center of similitude. This plays important role to find transverse common tangents. The point 1 comma 9 by 2 internal center of similitude plays important role to find the transverse common tangents. Next, we are going to find equations of transverse common tangents. Equations of transverse common tangents. Same like previous method. So here the point, the internal center of similitude point is 1 comma 9 by 2, and slope, let the slope of the transverse common tangent, one of the common tangent is m. Okay, then equation of tangent is y minus, this is x1, this is y1, y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1, 2 lcm. 2y minus 9 by 2 is equal to m into x minus 1. 2y minus 9 is equal to 2, bring to this side, 2m into x, 2mx, 2m into minus 1, minus 2m, bring to left side. Finally you will get 2mx minus 2y minus 2m plus 9, minus 9 become plus 9 is equal to 0. So this is a. So here a is equal, this is of the form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, a is equal to 2m, b is equal to minus 2, c is equal to minus 2m plus 9. So as this is the transverse common tangent, so here take any one of the two circle. So here I am taking second circle, and second circle this is the radius 3 and center is minus 2 comma 3. And we can observe radius is equal to perpendicular distance. If it is tangent, if there is a tangent line to the circle, the radius and perpendicular distance from center to the tangent both are equal, which we learn in earlier classes. Okay, so here observe radius 2, second radius is equal to perpendicular distance from center 2. What is center 2? Minus 2 comma 3 to this line, to line that is tangent. Okay, so that means what is radius 2? 3. Okay, perpendicular distance from center to this line, that is modulus of a 2m into x1 minus 2 b minus 2 into this is y1 3 minus 2m plus 9 c by under root of a square 2m square plus b square minus 2 square modulus of ax1 plus by1 plus c by under root of a square plus b square. Okay, now 3 into under root of, do cross multiplication, 4m square plus minus 2 square 4, which is equal to minus 4m minus 2m minus 6m, 2 into 2 minus 4m minus 2m minus 6m, 2 3 the 6 minus 6 plus 9 plus 3 modulus. Okay, so here 3 is common, what is remaining? 1 minus 2m, 3 3 cancel, squaring on both sides, 3 3 cancel, squaring on both sides, you will get 4m square, here square root cancel, 4m square plus 4 is equal to 1 square 1, 2m whole square, 4m square, a minus b whole square formula, a square plus b square minus 2ab, 2 to the 4m, a minus b whole square formula. Now 4m square minus 4m plus 1 minus 4 minus 3. Okay, so it is a quadratic equation. Observe here, this here I am telling one important point. It is a quadratic equation, okay, having two zeros. So one is this one and another is this one, slopes. Okay, so here 1 4m square getting cancelled means, so one root is not there, that means one root is, one value of m is not defined, and from this we will get another value of m. So 1m is not defined, here we cancelled, okay, m is not defined, that means we can take m is equal to not defined means 1 by 0, okay, treat it as 1 by 0. And from remaining, minus 4m plus 1 is equal to 4, minus 4m is equal to 4 minus 1, 3, m is equal to minus 3 by 4. So whenever one in a quadratic equation, square term gets cancelled, so one root is not defined, that means we can take 1 by 0. Okay, now we can find the equations of two common transverse common tangents by using point and slope. So first one, point is what? 1 comma 9 by 2, this is the point, this is the line, point line, okay, 1 comma 9 by 2, and one slope is, take it as 1 by 0, that means slope not defined means what? It is vertical line. Vertical line means what? It is x coordinate, that is x is equal to 1 is the equation. In straight line also you did this type of problems. If slope is not defined, that is possible for vertical line. Vertical line means x coordinate, that means x is equal to 1. So here y minus y1 9 by 2 is equal to m 1 by 0 into x minus x1, 0 into total 0, 1 into x minus 1, so x is equal, x minus 1 is equal to 0 is one equation. And second one, what is the point? 1 comma 9 by 2, and slope we got minus 3 by 4. So y minus 9 by 2 is equal to m into x minus x1. So here 2 LCM, 2y minus 9 minus 3 into x minus 1 by 4, 2 1s, 2 2s, 2 cross multiplication, 4y minus 2 9s are 18 minus 3 into x minus 3x minus 3 into 1 plus 3. So bring to left side, you will get plus 3x plus 4y minus 18 minus 3 minus 21 is equal to 0. So the two transverse common tangents are x minus 1 comma 3x plus 4y minus 2, x minus 1 is equal to 0, 1, 3x
minus 21 is equal to 0 is another. These are the two transverse common tangents. Okay, so this is one method, and I'm going to tell another one more method with by using s into s11 is equal to s1 square. So s into s11 is equal to s1 square. By using this method also, we can find these two common transverse common tangents. Okay, so here s means take any one of the two circles. I am taking first circle, so that is x square. So first write s is equal to what? X square plus y square minus 4x minus 10y plus 28 is equal to 0. In this 2g is equal to minus 4, g minus 2. 2f is equal to minus 10, f is equal to minus 5, c is equal to 28. S11 means substitute this point 1 comma 9 by 2. 1 square 9 by 2 whole square minus 4 into 1 minus 10 into 9 by 2 plus 28. So 1 plus 81 by 4 minus 4 minus 90 by 2 5 45 plus 28. So 81 by 4, this is 28 minus 45 minus 4 minus 49 plus 29, that is minus 20. So 81 minus 80, that is 1 by 4 is S11. Next S1 means x into x1. X1 is 1. Y into y1, 9 by 2 minus plus g, that is minus 2 into x plus x1, f minus 5 into y plus y1, c 28. So x plus 9y by 2 minus 2x minus 2 minus 5y minus 45 by 2 plus 28. 2 is the LCM, 2 into x, 2x, 9y, minus 4x, minus 4, minus 10y, minus 45, plus 28. So finally, 2x minus 4x, minus 2x, 9y minus 10y, minus y, minus 4, minus 45, minus 49, plus 28, minus 21 by 2. Okay, so this is S1. Now substitute all these values in S into S11 is equal to S1 square formula. So here all we got S value S11 as 1 by 4, and S1 is just here I did mistake, 228 for 56 and corrected. Now substitute that formula. S is x square plus y square minus 4x minus 10y plus 28 into S11, 1 by 4, and S1 square, this is S1, right? So simplify, I am simplifying this here. S1 square means 1 by 2 whole square into a plus b plus c whole square. What is the formula? A plus b plus c whole square formula. A square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. So a square means minus 2x whole square, that is 4x square. Otherwise write down minus 2x whole square minus y whole square 7 whole square. So a is minus 2x, b is minus y, c is 7. 2 minus 2x into minus y, 2 minus y into 7, 2 into 7 into minus 2x. So a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. So finally 1 by 2 whole square means 1 by 4 into minus 2x whole square, 4x square, y square, 49, 2 into this is plus 4xy, 2 into 7 minus 14y, 2 to the 4, 4 7 is 28x. So that is the value of S1 square. Okay, so 1 by 4 gets cancelled. Bring all term to right side, you will get 4x square plus y square plus 49 plus 4xy minus 14y minus 28x minus x square minus y square plus 4x plus 10y minus 28 is equal to 0.
So 4x square minus x square, 3x square, y square, y square gets cancelled, plus 4xy. These two terms completed, this term completed. 4x minus 28x minus 24x, 10y minus 14y minus 4y minus 28 plus 49 plus 21 is equal to 0. This is the combined equation of these two lines. Okay, now try to factorize this one. For this problem we can easily factorize this one. So here one important step, factor this one. So here 3x square plus 4xy, this can be written as minus 21x minus 3x, minus 21x minus 3x minus 24x. Okay, so from this x is common, what is remaining? 3x, 4y, minus 21. In this minus 1 is common, what is remaining? 3x, 4y, minus 21 is equal to 0. So again, what is common? 3x plus 4y minus 21 is common. Here x minus 1 is remaining. So these are two pair of lines. One is 3x plus 4y minus 21 is equal to 0, and another one is x minus 1 is equal to 0. These are two pair of tangent lines, transverse common tangents. So by using s into s11 is equal to s1 square formula also, we can find the equations of the transverse common tangents. So these two problems are direct common tangents, transverse common tangents. Problems are very, very important and lengthy problems. So we have to do more practice, then only we will get perfect on those two problems. So sometimes, many times they are asking for 7 marks also. So do practice. Okay, so this completes second bit problems. Practice thoroughly and get clarity on these problems. If you not get idea, if you will not get idea, then revise the video. Practice compulsory, you will get the perfectness on these problems. Okay, thank you.